Hello friends, today we are going to discuss NFA, or we can say NDFE, non-deterministic finite automata. As I already discussed about DFA in our previous lecture and different types of I already discussed four type of DFA property, DFA problem. Now next is NDFA or NFA. Okay. If I talk about the basic difference between the NFA and DFA is that in case of DFA, if I have a one state and I put a single input W or anything, it moves to a single output, that is Q1. But in case of NFA, if I have a initial state, that is Q0, and I put an input W, then it can, on a single input, in case of NFA, it can move to more than one state. Q1, Q2 up to Qn. So this is the basic difference between DFA and NFA. The basic real life example of NFA is a chess game. For that, in the chess game, similarly like a chess game, we, for a single move, for a single input, I can move many, I can have the opportunity, I can have the, I can able be to move a many moves. So in case of DFA, with a single input, we have a single output. But in case of NFA, with a single input, I have more than one output. Now, as I know that you already study about NFA in your subject theory of computation, and today we are using NFA in our compiler design, so here we discuss some of the problems of NFA. Okay, and then we carry on to the next topic. Okay, now as like DFA, NFA also have a 5 tuples, which is equals to Q, sigma, transition function, Q0 and F. Okay, where S is a set of final state, Q0 is your initial state, but here this transition function is equals to Q, a set of all final states, into your sigma, that is an input, union of, I can also take this epsilon move, and this whole transition function gives 2 to the power Q. Okay. The rest of the tuples are similar, just like DFA. But the difference between NFA and DFA in the terms of tuple, that is transition function. Now, I discuss some of the examples, simple examples of NFA, that how we create NFA for some set of strings. For example, first we suppose that I have to construct a NFA for all strings that starts with A. If I have an input AB equals to A comma B. Okay. Now I have to draw an NFA which contain a string which always starts with A, and I don't care what comes in at the end of the string. So how you create the NFA? If Q1 is your initial state, so I draw like this, and it always starts with A. So initially the first input is A, it always starts with A, and it moves to next state Q2, which is a final state, and the final state can have A, either A or B. I only care that it always starts with A, and I don't care what comes in at the end. So this is how we create a NFA for all the string starts with A. Now suppose another example. I have to draw an NFA for all strings which contain A. Okay, either in the beginning or in the middle or in the end. So how you draw? Suppose Q1 is your initial state. So either at the beginning, it can be A or it can be B. In the next state, it can be a A, and at the final state, it can A or B. So, if I accept any string which contains A, it can easily accept to this NFA. Okay. Now, move to the third example. Now, I have to create an NFA for all strings which ends with A. Just similar, or you can say just opposite of this NFA. If Q1 is the initial state, okay, here I have to care that the string is always ends with A. I don't care what comes in the beginning, whether it comes with A or it comes to B. It always ends with, if Q2 is the final state, it always ends with A. So this is how we draw the NFA. Okay. Now suppose fourth example, I have to create an NFA for all strings which starts with AB, consecutively AB. Means if Q1 is the initial state, so the first input comes, it's A, it moves to next state, that is Q2, then after A, B comes, so it always starts with A, B, and then it comes to this final state Q3, and I don't care whether A or B come at the end. The main part is that it always starts with A, B consecutively. At the end, whether it comes with A or B, I do not care whatever be the string is. Okay. Now, next example, I have to draw an NFA for all strings which contains AB. It's just similar to the second example, that is contain A. So, if Q1 is the initial state, I don't care what comes at the beginning. It can A either B, but it contains A. Okay, it moves to the Q2 state, then comes B, and it moves to the final state, that is Q3, and I don't care what comes at the end. Either A come or B come. It means in the beginning A and B also contain in the string, in the middle and in the last. So it fulfill the string which contains AB. Now next, I have to draw an NFA for all strings which ends with AB. Okay, how you draw? Like this. If Q1 is the initial state, I don't care what comes in the beginning, whether it comes A or B, it always ends with A, B. So this NFA accept all the strings which ends with AB. Okay. Now we take some more example. Okay. Next is seventh example. I have to draw NFA for all strings of length 2 exactly. Okay. String of length 2 exactly. Okay. It means the language will be AA, AB, BA or BB. Okay. So the language contains exactly 2 length. String having 2 length. How will you draw? It means initially Q1 is the initial state. It shows 0 length. Then A or B comes. Then it moves to Q2. It shows length one length, and then it moves to Q3, which is the final states. Here it can be A or B, and it shows two length. This state shows 0 length, this state shows 1 length, and this state shows 2 length, which is the final state, because the string contain exactly 2 length. Okay. Now the next example, I have to draw an NFA of length at least two. At least means minimum two, maximum will be anything. So if Q1 is the initial state, okay, so if this shows length 0, Q2, this shows length 1, then we have Q3, this shows 2 length, and here on the final state, I create a loop with the input AB. If this shows n number of length, means 0 length, 1 length, 2 length, and many more. Okay. And one more example, I have to create an NFA for string of length at most 2. Means the language will contain a length maximum of 2, minimum of 0, 1, and 2. So how you draw? If Q1 is the initial state, it is of 0 length, AB, Q2, and Q3. Here A and B, either A or B. So 0 length will also accept to this NFA. So Q1 is also a final state. At most 2 condition means you can this NFA also accept 1 length string. So Q2 will also a final state, and Q3 will also a final state. So this is how we create an NFA. Okay. And now, after draw all these NFA, as we know that DFA is a subset of NFA, which means that DFA, I can say from DFA I can draw NFA, or you can say all DFA are NFA. Okay, if I convert NFA from NFA to DFA, okay, then I can say that NFA is equivalent to DFA. Okay, so this property you already know, that all DFA are NFA, or you can say DFA is a subset of NFA. So this property is true. Now our next topic is that how we convert NFA into DFA. So please see our next video for this conversion, that is conversion from NFA to DFA. I hope you can understand all the solution, all the some simple example to how to create an NFA. Okay, I hope you enjoy it, and if you like our videos or like our topic, or if you have any doubt, then please you can ask our your query and place your query in our comment section, and please subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching.